Teach you something also that can help you on your submission. Can you read Matthew 27? I'll give you scriptures, Matthew 27. Teach you on your submission. Let's read from 3. We read to 8. Can I read for you? Then Judas, who betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, saying, I have sinned in that I betray innocent blood. But they said, what is it thou to us? See thou to it. And he cast down the pieces of silver into the sanctuary and departed. And he went away and hanged himself. And the chief priest took the pieces of silver and said, it is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since it is the price of the blood. And they took counsel and brought with them the potter field and bought with them the potter field to bury strangers in. Wherefore that field was called the field of the blood unto this day. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I was learning something here where we have read that truly Jesus was supposed to go through this.
Supposed
to go to the cross. Supposed to face what he was supposed to be facing. And unfortunately, there was life of Judas. The life of Judas was unfortunate. I want to talk about betrayal. Betrayal is still there even today. Betrayal. If you can read there, you will realize that the Bible is clear to indicate that whoever betrays does not benefit. There is two things. When somebody betrays, number one is the one who betrays receives destruction. And the one who's betrayed, he goes to a level of no return. Can I say this to you? If God wants to raise you, someone must betray you. And the level you will go to is called no return level. Tell everybody, there's a no return level. Jesus, after this betrayal, though Judas sent back the money, there was no way of changing the sentence of Jesus.
But
it was a way to his glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell my friend, if you face betrayal, don't fight it. If we read John 13:2, how do we betray? In John 13 verse 2.
John 13 verse 2.
I'm reading there. And during supper, the devil, having already put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him.
Amen.
In other words, you can't betray unless devil find your heart. Listen to this. I found that the Bible says it's only God who searches the heart. But listen, though it's God who searches the heart, you have right to maintain your heart. You have a heart. You've got an opportunity to deal with your own heart. The Bible says, Satan find a space.
Satan atola munyeta.
And he put a seed of betrayal. So that Judas will rise up.
Judas apahame.
Against Jesus.
Can
you see? Jesus, as I said in the beginning, he was worthy to go through what he supposed to go through.
Same
applies to you. You are supposed to go through what you are supposed to go. But woe to the one who betrayed. Trouble to the one who betrayed. Because to him or her, the destiny is destruction. I don't know if you're hearing
that.
If you read the same chapter from verse 8, we found that still that Jesus could not stop this man not to betray him. If you read, let's read verse 8 there.
Verse 8,
on the same chapter. He said, Peter saith unto him, thou shalt never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, if I wash thee not, thou hast no part with me. 9, Simon Peter said unto him, Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Jesus saith to him, he that is bathed needeth to save to wash his feet, but is clean every whit. And ye are clean, but not all. Can you see that verse? You are clean, but not all.
For he knew
him that should betray him. Therefore said, ye are not all clean. Look at verse
12.
He says, so when he had washed their feet and taken his garments and sat down again, he said unto them, know ye what I have done to you? Ye call me teacher and the Lord, and ye say, well, for so I am. If I then, the Lord and the teacher, have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet. Can you see that?
Amen.
In other words, Jesus was trying to say, though you find your betrayer, that betrayer must never affect your mission.
Jesus,
Jesus knew the betrayer. But still, he said, let me wash their feet, and he even washed the feet of
Judas.
He understood who was betraying him.
But
he announced it and said, someone will betray. You know, I was reading this, I was shocked to find that you will never know the betrayers by looking at the appearance. It took Jesus to find it by revelation. And still, when he found that, he could not chase away Judas. I remember the last time he said, when he saw
Judas
coming with the army, he said, there comes my friend. In other words, you are my friend because you are helping me to go to a level of no return. Many enemies, many people were with us and who are against us now. You were not supposed to have fought them. You are here because of them. They did what they did so that God
would
promote you. There's a level that God set in life. But you must be betrayed. That's why you must be betrayed. The person who betray you will never betray you when he's far. He must come close to you and know all corners about you. Can you see that many people who are coming close to us? They are not there for fantasy. They are there to lift you. I don't know if you're hearing me. The moment you see destruction, the moment you see shame, rejection from them, fear not. There's a level. There's a level. Can you say there's a level? Do you know what happened to me? Some people, they lie about me. And they said that when they left the ministry, they said they're the ones who were supporting. The ministry will die within 3 months. After they left, on that 3 months, I was having overflow. There are some people that must leave you. Don't fight them. Let them leave you for the glory of the living God. If you read in Matthew 26, verse 20 to 25, you can see no extra sign that prove this is a betrayer. Because you see, that's why we need to have a discerning spirit. You can see there, there was no sign to prove Judas was a betrayer. I can give you an example. Even Jesus trusted Judas. He was the one who was holding money. He was managing. I remember when Mary came with something like alabaster oil. When she broke it, Judas was complaining.
Judas ya thoma abilaela.
He said, no, you see this, we're supposed to have sold it. In other words, Judas was there for the business of the ministry to grow. So what is the first instance issue that makes Jesus to trust
Judas?
What was the reason behind? No, there was no sign. Many people do come to church, there was no sign. Some of them, they become your friends. Whereas they are teaching you how to betray. So that you lose what God is supposed to do about your life. I remember we attended one church with my wife. When we reached there, we said, let's support the pastor. And we found that the whole church was saying no. We were just like, we are two members. And the whole church was betrayers. And we said, let's do something. My wife stood up and said, sorry. Can we buy grocery for the church? Let's make sure that the pastor must eat. You know, people came and say, you are new here. You know nothing. So you are new. We know this pastor. Already they have betrayed. Because betrayer bring a divorcee spirit. The reason why people are in the church and they are not part of the vision is because of betrayer. And from there, when God searches for them, they can't find them. Because God in the church, He wants to show His wisdom. But when He wants to show wisdom, He found those people are no longer in the church. They are fighting the servants of the living God. If you remember, it happened to Moses. When God was using Moses, and the sister was close, the sister was close.
Why
it's like God speaks with him alone. And the Bible says God was angry because he saw what will happen to Moses. Because once a betrayer affects the people who are
far.
And therefore it means people will repent against the vision that God was placing in the life of Moses. And what happened was leprosy came. Sometimes there are challenges that come to you because God is speaking. God will say, don't betray. If we can go and try to find people who have betrayed, many of them are suffering. Many of them are sick. Many of them are poor. They are facing challenges. Because betrayal produces destruction. Betrayal, I want to say betrayal produces destruction to the betrayer. If you read John 6, verse 64, it says, when you do not believe, you are a good tool of betrayal. Just read that verse aloud in your Bible. John 6, verse 1.
64.
Can you read that verse aloud in your Bible?
Fela mogole na ona le ba bangwe ba ba sadumelewo go bane go tloga mathomong Jesu o be ya tseka gore ba ba dumelao ke bafe le gore ya tlo moeka ke mang.
So you can see there that the people who don't believe are being mentioned with betrayal. It is easy that when you don't believe, you betray. It is so easy. If you say you are in Charis,
and
you don't believe anything about Charis, it's easy. You
are
a tool. If you don't believe, you become a tool of Satan to bring betrayal. Let me say it again. If you don't believe, you become a tool of Satan to bring betrayal. Can you be in a ministry where you believe? No. I'm saying, can you be in the ministry where you believe? It's better you go to a ministry where you believe. That's what I'm saying. Than to be in the ministry where you have got some questions. Because Satan will use you. You will become a weak vessel. You will turn your mind and use your mind. Be in a church where you believe God. I don't know if you are hearing me.
Tazo,
be in a church where you believe God. Because betrayers, they become a tool that Satan uses. In John 18, verse 1 to 6. Betrayers, they have to know the secrets that other people they don't know. Listen to this. Judas here,
Judas Mo,
knew where Jesus used to go and pray. And he found a way to betray him. Because he knew that Jesus is weak. Can I give you a question? Why Judas could not come in public?
Why Judas asa ataba tuka mukabali ting?
why he come where Jesus is praying alone?
Why ai ya kwale a tsebang gore Jesu o ile o rapela le di?
He knew what Jesus will do.
Jesus in prayer.
He will make sure that his flesh is weak. Remember the time when he prayed and his shirt changed to be like blood. So Judas knew the secret place of
Jesus.
So if you want to be a good betrayer, you need to know all the corners of the one you are betraying so that you'll be able to betray. I'm teaching you how to betray. Find a way from corners. You want to go deep and search.
But
when you find, you know where he's alone. Because Jesus never believed in majority. When he goes to pray, he will leave the disciples and move forward. Remember when Jesus wake up, he said, from prayer, when they came there, so if you are seeking me, leave these ones to go. Listen, Jesus, though he had power, he could not use it. He understood the level he was going to. He said, whom are you seeking? They say, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He says, it's me. And they fall down. But he never do anything. He asked them again. Listen to this. There is power that raises someone. The one who has been betrayed can go to a higher level. And that level is a level of no return. Somebody here today, you are going to a level of no return. They are betraying you where you are working and don't fight them. In business, don't fight them. In whatever, in families, don't worry. There's a level that God is raising you and no one will be able to stop you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Ask us, my friend. Did you ever face betrayal? It's a nice level of destroying your enemies. I don't know if you're hearing me. It's a nice level of selecting those who are not worthy to be with you. Because when they come closer, you don't know why they are there. They must betray you so that they face destruction and you go to another level. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Say somebody, say, hey, I'm going to another level. Also, you are tested when you are betrayed. You are tested. Because, you know, the reason why you won't fight is because you know whom you depend on. So you won't fight because you know the one who put you there. Who put you to that job, you know him. Who gave you that job, you know him. Who's giving you that house, that marriage, you know him. Don't worry when they fight against you. Don't worry when they are against you. Don't worry when they are gossiping. Just laugh because it's another level. I'm going to another level. I prophesy someone. You are going to a level of no return. I say a level of no return. It is your portion. It is your life. And you will never fall again. Listen, you must stop fighting for yourself. You hear me? You must stop doing what?
Fighting for yourself.
Because you won't feel good. Fighting for yourself when you hear somebody say this about you want to talk. So can you start now to be and see the one who called you lifting you? Listen, do you know why God uses power of resurrection? Can I tell you? Is when they speak against you, you are. They fight you, you are. They They oppose you, you
are.
And God said, no. I didn't place my child in the grave, in that limitation, in that stagnation. Resurrect to another level. Shake somebody say, hey, someone here is going to another level. Tell somebody and say, it's you. Look at this verse. In Mark 14, verse 44. You can be very surprised there
that
betrayers, they have their talking. The betrayers, they are dangerous. They talk. You are sitting here, they are winking. Especially to you, pastors. Pastors, you don't know betrayers are many in your churches. When you are busy preaching, they are writing. You think they are writing notes. They are talking about the way you are wearing. Even the zero you are preaching. When you say hallelujah, they say amen. But what they are writing is not what you are preaching. There are many, many betrayers. They've got their own token. Sign of their communication. Judas said to the people he came with, if I kiss, arrest him. And here, the disciples were thinking about, maybe Judas, this guy, because he's a man of money, he's a minister of finance. They are coming to kiss Jesus, to lift him to be a prime minister. There was a different communication between the betrayers and the disciples. It's only when now they had to fight and arrest Jesus. Peter saw it. He removed a sword and cut someone's ear. And Jesus said, no, let us not use the language of betrayers. We are different with betrayers. This is my level. Jesus could still heal the person who's against him. Jesus could still heal. He took the ear and put it back. And the man, when after he's healed, he said, let's arrest him. It's happening today. Many people you have helped, they are against you. Carry on helping them. You are going to another level. Ask somebody, say, my friend, why are you not forgiving?
Why you now level?
It's when you consider that what has been happening to you is permanent. If you know that this thing that has happened to you, it will take you to another level, you won't worry. The reason why you are having a spirit of unforgiving, complaining, wanted to fight on your own, you don't know the reason why you face what you face. It's a level. I say it's a level. Tell me, my friend, I'm going to a level. Don't stop me, I'm going to a level. Don't block me, I'm going to a level. Do you know, nobody can block us. Do you read the scriptures in Romans
8?
It talks about no one can say anything if God is with us. Who can be against us? Whatever you are facing, there's someone here today. You are listening to the sound of my voice. I tell you, you are going to another level. This is a level of no return. Gone are the days of worrying about what you face. Gone are the days of considering the shame you encounter. It is a level. Whatever you might have faced in life, it has brought you to this level today. Now, you are going to another level. I say, you are going to another level. How many of you believe that today? Say, I'm going to another level. Listen. The more you suffer betrayals, the more your level of prayer
raises.
So it's also like God wants to take you to a level where he can communicate with you. The reason why you are suffering what you are suffering is not a bad omen. It's a challenge to the one who's against you, but lift it to you to
level.
If you believe, shout hallelujah. Can you ask your neighbor? Do you understand that? Never challenge anybody by his challenges. Never reject somebody because of his
challenge.
Never betray anybody. Because whatever you say against someone, it can bring a key of destruction. Everybody is entitled to rise up. Before you rise up, you must go down. And you go up. Thank God for what you have been facing. Today, you go to a higher level. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Congratulations. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We were in a class. Our ministry was confined in a classroom.
I came to see
the man of God.
One on one.
Immediately, the class filled up.
We
hired a 210-seater, it filled up. Then we have bought a 300-seater tent, and we are now thanking God for the grace that is upon the church in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Greetings to everybody in the name of Jesus Christ. I want to thank God he has blessed me with a baby boy. Greetings, people of God. I'm Eva. On the Sunday that we're celebrating the birthday of Apostle, he said to us that we can take our CVs wherever we want to take them.
So Monday,
I took my CV to the hospital the following day. It was a Monday. When I got there, they just asked me, when are you willing to start working?
Next month, today.
I said next month, and they said to me that it is better that you start working today.
If you're one of my patients, the Aban regularly by the present their Bible.
Bolelang rapesesi?
If you're among my patients, the Jaga, I'm pretty sure I can language.
One of the patients asked me, which language am I speaking? I told him or her that I speak Northern Sotho. And that person bought me a baby Bible. I thank God for all this. Amen.
Greetings in the name of Jesus.
Madumeli ningla Jesu.
I want to thank the God of Charis for delivering me here. Wherever I've gone, I've been a vagabond for a long time. I just want to say I found home in
Charis.
I've been delivered. And my debts have been paid. I don't know how. I have a debt that was worrying me. When I was prayed for here, for the first time I came here, because I've been rejected in most places where I need to be prayed for, they'll just pass me by. But here, the apostle came there and said, I see a demon and I'm shocked. He faced it head on. Because I was even thinking, maybe I have the worst demon that all the prophets are afraid of.
But
I was prayed for and I was rejoicing. I took those depths, I cancelled, I prayed and cancelled.
When I got home, I prayed that God must cancel my debts.
They were all cancelled. I was unemployed, I can't pay for them. So I thank God. Hallelujah.
So we thank God. Hallelujah. Clap hands for yourself. I'm very happy for you. I have pastors here. You can stand up, pastors. Yes. Clap hands for pastors who are here. Congratulations. God bless you. We have my visitors that I will be seeing them tomorrow. You can stand. My brother is back from Australia. You are back. He's from Australia. He's back. You came alone? You came alone. All right, you're from Australia, I know. Another one from outside is. Yes. Can you stand up, my visitor? Stand up, we want to see you. You're from where?
Burkina Faso.
Burkina Faso, you can see. Burkina Faso is also far. Yes?
From Switzerland.
From where?
Switzerland.
Switzerland. You can hear Switzerland. Switzerland. So, another one from outside? Okay, these other people we are going to be with them. Even my sister from where? The one of the char. From where?
Austria.
Austria.
Vienna.
You can hear Vienna.
Yes.
Vienna. You know Vienna? Switzerland, you know? Schwitz. You know? So thank you. And we have you South Africans. Clap hands for all of them. We have Mama. Okay, you can see that we have our pastor from Botswana here. And welcome.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
I think coming here is to revive yourself.
Amen.
And receive strength to move forward. Welcome. Yes, God bless you.
Amen.
Yes. Pastor from, also of Charis from even Zimbabwe. You know, you've got a branch in Zimbabwe also. Clap hands for him. You know him. Uh-huh. Victoria, also stand up. We have Corombi there. God bless you. Also clap hands for yourself. If you want to be healed, run. One. Okay. Yeah, the way you are running now, because you have never run for anything. When your boyfriend says, come here, you just say, okay. Because you know your boyfriend begs you. Eh? There is something. Listen, when you say, when your boyfriend says, come here, can you come here? You just say, because you know that there is something that you have which is important, that your boyfriend is searching for you. So if you know that I'm carrying something important here, when I call you, you must run. It's as simple as that. You believe you can be healed?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Where's your boyfriend?
I don't have.
Oh, shame. Shame, sister. You are healed. You have one. Can I get one here? You see? You see, brother? How long you are HIV?
4 weeks.
4 weeks?
45.
Jesus has healed you.
Amen.
Can I get one then? You see, you too, you are running. Stop here. You see? HIV is a problem.
HIV.
When we say Jesus can heal people now, they say they find something that can heal. In the beginning, they say there's nobody who can heal HIV. Now they say we found something that can heal.
You know,
the world is too much. How long your HIV, sister?
4 months.
My brother?
5 years.
5 years.
Yeah. 5 years.
Same time, you people, you are healed. You are healed forever. Can I get another one? Stop there, stop there. The way you are running is so nice, but don't overtake, eh? How long your HIV?
It's been 4 months.
Yourself?
Since 1998.
I command this HIV to leave you now. Come on.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you are free. Can I get another one there? HIV want to be here? Okay, they are this side only. Oh, they know we call people of HIV this side. Oh. How long your HIV, my brother?
I found out today.
Today? Yeah. Sorry, eh? So what if you go back again and make a check? You can find it's negative.
Okay.
Yes. What about you?
It's been 5 years.
5 years?
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 26.
Touch it. I release you in Jesus' name. Come on, you demon of HIV.
Amen.
It's a demon. Don't hold it. Leave it. Put a mic in your mouth. It's a demon, that one. Leave it. Leave it. Leave it. Leave it with that demon. Make sure that she doesn't hit there. See, HIV is a demon. HIV. Demon. You see? You see? Look at her. Out! Out, you demon! Come on! Can I get another one?
Come on.
Two of you, five. Go, stop there. Can you go back? Can you go back? How long your HIV, my brother?
5 years.
Huh?
5 years.
Since 1999. 7 years.
7 years. We can see our brothers and sisters are suffering because of HIV.
Amen.
If Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever, he can heal them.
Amen.
Lift up your head. Receive healing.
Amen.
You are free. You are free. You are all free.
Amen.
Can I get another one? The last one is fine. How long your age have you, my brother?
From last year.
Last year.
Yeah.
Are you in ARV?
No.
You are free. Can I get another one? Stop there. How old are you?
31.
How long your HIV?
6 months.
6 months. It's very good for you. Very good. This HIV is very good for you because it has brought you here. You could not come here, you. You could not even come here.
Now, that's
it's not true.
Yes.
Huh?
Yeah, it's
true. Huh?
It's true.
Because you don't believe in people like me. Now you are believing because of HIV. Demo of HIV. Out! Vani! Vani! Hold there, hold there. Nikumitani!
What are you doing?
Huh?
Huh?
Leave me.
Nikumitani, one of you.
What are you doing in here?
Nikumitani, Abani! Why no more HIV, Aban?
Why did you give her
HIV?
She makes herself better.
Can you hear that? No more the HIV.
How did you give her the HIV?
Abani!
Abani!
No more.
How did you give her HIV? She's now pregnant.
Not true.
Leave me.
HIV and you're pregnant. It's painful. But thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
Who love his people. In Jesus' name. It's over.
It's Amen. Over.
Can I get one person who's diabetic? Stop
diabetic.
There. Stop there. Diabetes. You are living a diabetes.
Amen.
Come on. Ouch. You diabetes. Not this disease. They don't have respect of. Ouch. Diabetes. Go. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's over.
Amen.
Can I get another one? Come, sir. When you run like this, the job is half done. When
Amen.
I touch you,
Amen.
You are healed.
Amen.
Can I get one diabetes? How long you are diabetic?
3 years. Huh? 3 years.
3 years.
Today, Jesus is healing you.
Amen.
You are free. Can I get one who wants a child? Yeah, come. This lady, the way she ran, when do you want a child?
Now.
Now?
Yes.
Take your child. Take! Stand up! Come on! You demon in the womb. Out! Funny! It's a demon in the womb. Out! Demon in the womb. Shining fire! What are you doing in the womb?
I'm going to turn in the womb.
Huh? Fire all over your body. Another one wanted a child. You see the way she ran this one? No, don't just run and stay in front of me that way. Come here, this one. This one she believed. Come on! Hold there. You demon of HIV. You block the child. You are defeated.
Amen.
She's free. Can I get another one who want a child, this one? You want a child?
Yes.
Let me see, how old are you?
49.
Yes. I want people like this way. Get your child. Come on. Come on. Out. Out. Leave the womb.
Amen.
Out. Out. Come out. Leave. Come on. Hurry. Can I get another one that side? One person. I will choose the one who's running better. You are all running better. Eh? You are not running. Come, these two. You people go back. Otherwise, we're supposed to be having children. Can you just wake up and have a child? No, you must have faith. And to have faith, it means you must work. Faith without works is dead. What kind of child do you want, my sister?
Boys.
Boy?
Yeah.
Why boy?
I like it.
Why boy?
Because I've got one girl. She's just 25.
Your first girl is 25.
Mm.
Yourself, you don't have a child.
Yeah, I have now.
Huh?
I have at all.
Receive. You are free. Can I get the last one? Stop here. Oh, are you married?
Yes, I am.
Where is your husband?
He's at work.
You must bring him for a go back. You must come with your husband.
Okay.
Your husband is the one who's having a problem, eh?
Okay.
Yeah. So you must come with your husband, eh?
Okay.
Are you married?
No.
Okay. Are you married? Where is your husband?
William Miragom.
Are you married?
God.
Okay. Let me bless you. You are blessed.
Amen.
Shake it with me. When do you want to get married?
At any time.
You want to marry or you want a child?
I want a child before.
You want a child before you marry?
Yes.
Where were you sitting?
I'm staying at Rustenburg.
Now, where were you sitting here?
No,
I come from Rustenburg.
Where were you sitting in the church?
No,
that side.
You are sitting with who there? Is she also married? Are you friends or what?
Are you free?
Oh. Can you come together?
The fellowship together in Rustenburg.
Call her. Awesome. Call your friend.
I was label.
This is a problem. You want me to sin against God, to pray for you, to go and do jolly. Are you standing, attending one church together?
Yes, sir.
Are you married?
Yes, I'm married, Minya.
Why you don't advise her if you are married concerning living Christian life? What kind of church are you attending?
It's an agreement.
I've not been long in that church. I've got only maybe 3 weeks or 4 weeks. I'm new in the ministry.
So you find a friend?
Yeah.
You find this one in the church?
Yes.
You don't know her?
I don't know her background. We just met in the church.
You just meet in the church, you're a friend. 3 weeks, you're a friend. It's easy. So you don't know anything about this lady?
No, sir, I don't know her.
Yeah. So, my sister, okay, let me advise you. If you're a Christian, there is no issue of time is gone. Or you are left behind. You do things in the right way. If you want a child now, so that you marry, it's a wrong way. Can you believe God in a marriage?
Huh?
Amen.
Can you do that?
Yes.
Are you sure you can do that?
Yes, Prophet.
Huh?
Yes, Prophet.
I want to stand with you. Me and you, we believe that you can marry, you will marry. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, I believe.
So where is your boyfriend?
He's at home.
Does he know that you are a Christian?
What's the word?
So why he want a child before you marry?
Why I want to marry so young?
Kaleba kala khore kitere seba kake sakreba na no kena kana khore jaratsa ka diatsama.
I was thinking my years are going by, and now I have taken a very long time.
That's the reason I'm trying to tell you that there is no issue of you have been delayed or you are late. Tell him that you met me and I'm saying you people must do things in the right way. If you want to marry you because of a child, it's wrong. You hear me? You're a Christian. You are what? Are you a Christian?
Yes.
Huh? What are you doing in the church?
I'm Asher. Yeah,
Asher.
Yeah, Asher.
Your boyfriend is doing what?
Hardly kerking at all.
He does not go to church at all.
Does your pastor know your boyfriend? Can you see? Pastor, does he know that?
What is he saying about
him? If your pastor know this one is a boyfriend, why he take you to be an usher? I mean, why pastor took you to be an usher if you know you people you are jolly?
Murutu dia yang asharatsi woro wena alidita wakamo chau jola.
My sister, you know the questions I'm asking you is not to condemn you.
The butcha jage vushanga si watula.
But I want to show you a way.
Kya kuvanchatsela.
You people, you are the one who can go to the pastor. Pastor,
don't
make me an usher. I'm jolly.
Skantira ashara kisana levo tata.
The reason why I'm jolling is this. Pastor, we
jolly so katavaya se.
But now, what are you ushering?
When I just don't ushering.
Yeah, you didn't sleep home yesterday. You are ushering on Sunday. So God loves you. Let's stand together.
Amen.
You pray the prayer of confession. Do you want to do that?
Onye gode rasim.
And then now, this brother, you go to him and tell him, you see what? I want to live a holy life. I want to follow Jesus. And you marry me in a right way. And then it will happen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You say hallelujah for all? You say my name is hallelujah. You hear what I said? If I pray for you, I'm sinning against God. If I don't cancel you, I'm telling you what I did here is zero. I'm like you. I'm sure. That's what the Bible says. We must not run to lay hands on people.
Amen.
If now I lay hands on you, I have sinned against God. I'm telling you. Do you want to do things in the right way?
Huh?
You want to marry?
Yes.
You want the same brother to marry you? Do you want the same brother to marry you? Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. You're a laugh, is it? Please. If you want to accept Jesus, pray with her. Pray for accepting Jesus. But take my words. When you go back to the brother, tell him that, listen, please listen. I know what happened to you. It might be, you can find it's an attack. You hear me? That has brought this delay. And you cannot fight this attack when you are sinning. You understand what I'm trying to say?
Amen.
So you, what you can do, you can accept Jesus here
and confess,
pray with prayer of accepting
Jesus.
When you go back, you tell the brother, I was sinning. Sex before marriage is sin.
Amen.
So can you marry me? Let's do the right thing. You marry me. And you also, I want you to follow Jesus. You tell this brother, because you cannot just say you want to marry anybody.
Amen.
You just say, okay, I want you to follow Jesus. If this brother said no, cut relationship. Cut this relationship.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
From there, you go back now, you usher with open spirit in the church, you are serving God. God will never leave his children.
Amen.
There's no time late. There's nothing called late before God.
Amen.
1,000 years is close to one day.
Amen.
You got me? So pray with her prayer of accepting Jesus. I'm saying this because I love her so much. She's a beautiful woman. Satan has used a weapon to block her, you know, so that she must not marry. But now listen, the mistake we are doing, you young people, is issue like this. You feel like you look at yourself, you compare yourself with your friends. Your friends are married. Now, the moment you reach 30 years, 31 years, you begin to complain. And you forget that the plan of God in your life must differ with other people's lives. And now you want to be like your friends. If somebody say, I don't love you, thank God. God will give you the right person. Hold him. Hold God. You'll see something. But if you just look at this person, why don't you? Why don't you, Mara? You go and look at yourself in the mirror. You will see an ugly person of yourself. I don't know if you're hearing me. You reject yourself. You won't eat food. From there, you lose your calves. You lose everything about yourself. But now, if you're excited, you just, thank God. You are very small to me. That's why you're leaving me. You live a holy life. God will give you a right partner. You must ask me, I will tell you. You must ask me. I know some people here that came to Charis here after they face problem, challenges, whatever. And God makes them to meet. There is peace in them. But if you just say, okay, my friend, you just turn around, you are doomed. You are what? Don't judge yourself by other people. Do things right. You are here. You just say, okay, no, I've seen a downfall or maybe somebody rejected me or whatever. But I want to follow God until something happens. You'll be surprised if you have got 3 children. Somebody will say, please, I want to marry you. I even know you've got 3 children. And you say, I didn't tell you. He says, no, I've been doing investigation. I found you are the one. I need to marry. And when you look, you realize it's better than that stupid who left you. I don't know if you're hearing me. So stop complaining. Glory be to God. Wherever you are, can you receive the grace of God upon your life? Can you receive anointing upon your life? Can you receive what you are here for? How many of you knows that by me coming here, you are changing your destiny? You are changing your destiny. Huh? You know that? Receive anointing that breaks the yoke.